Is the new Konnected Joe from Kamado Joe all hype? Or is it revolutionary, like they say?
It doesn't matter whether it's a smartphone or a grill. You buy a shiny new one on Friday, and Monday morning they come out with a new and even better one. Am I right? You might remember that I tried to prove the Kamado Joe was all hype, and lost. James from Smokin' Dad Barbecue proved that Kamado Joe actually innovated over the Big Green Egg, and that the slow roller from Kamado Joe turned out to be a real game changer. So I lost in our Big Green Egg Kamado Joe challenge and had to get a Kamado Joe of my own, Obi-Wan, who's sitting over here over my shoulder. And honestly, I love this thing. Like, I'm really glad that I upgraded. It is a fabulous grill and it is a step way up from the Big Green Egg. Happy with Kamado Joe. But sure enough, with my luck, I've got this thing for a couple of months and Kamado Joe comes out with the latest and greatest, the new thing. They launch a brand new model, a fully automated, connected Kamado cooker that they say is gonna revolutionize backyard grilling. Looking back, it all makes sense. With the Series 2, Kamado Joe added the airlift hinge, the control tower top, the mesh gasket, a multi-piece firebox, metal shelves, and then the Series 3, they changed the game again. They changed the shape and made it bigger, added a three-tier divide and conquer rack. They added the slow roller, which, like I said before, was a real game changer in how food tastes. And they created this new heavy-duty sturdy stand that's actually pretty good if you're not using a table. So by that logic, the newest product that they announced this week should be based on the one they had two generations ago. No slow roller, no charcoal basket, no three-tier divide and conquer. What's the deal here? Oh, and by the way, it says you can't use it inside, duh. But you can't apparently use it outside either, as the manual says, no rain or snow ever, even when it's not in use. And you can't use it under an awning or an overhang, so it's red. It has to be kept in the garage when it's not in use. It's basically a Ferrari, except it's not gonna help me get dates with beautiful women. That's what Boba Fett, my stick burner, and Obi-Wan, my Kamado Joe are for. Well, don't be sad, because I think I can upgrade my Big Joe with all those accessories into something even better than the Konnected Joe. And to be honest, I don't know if spending $1,700 for this new product is a good idea anyway. I'll show you what I'm thinking in a few minutes, but first let's take a look at what's new with the Konnected Joe. This is probably a good time to share with you that I was not one of the folks that was lucky enough to get invited to get a pre-release edition of the Konnected Joe. But that's okay. I don't think I would have said yes anyway. I mean, would it have been nice to be invited? Sure, right? You don't call, you don't write anymore. What am I, chopped liver?
I'd like to thank the Academy. It's such an honor just to be nominated.
First, let's explore what the new Konnected Joe really is. It's basically a Kamado Joe Classic 2 with a temperature monitor and a fan built in for about $1,700. It's got the same airlift hinge, control tower top, the same metal side shelves, the multi-piece firebox, the ash drawer, and the same solid Kamado Joe construction as the Series 2. They gave it the stand from the Series 3, so it's got that going for it, which is nice. It's also got handles on the sides to make it easier to lift, something I hope they add to all their future grills, because that might have saved us from the hardest part of setting up Obi-Wan here. If you want to take it with you somewhere, like camping, those handles are going to come in really handy, as long as you have a campsite with electricity, and it doesn't rain, or snow, or I guess humidity is probably going to be an issue too. I guess there's a reason I take a Weber kettle with me when I go camping, and it doesn't need handles. But those handles are nice, like they're gonna come in handy. So Kamado Joe, keep that up, put those on future products. The other thing they've added, which I think is a really nice feature, is an automatic starter. It's like literally push a button and it starts the fire. But that starter comes from the bottom. I really wish they'd found a way to put that heat for the starter on top, because the right way to light a Kamado Joe is to stack the charcoal and then light the charcoal on top so that only that lights and then it burns down. That's how you maintain a controlled burn. You don't want all of the charcoal to light, and if you light it from the bottom, the heat rises and all that charcoal is gonna light. But I probably wouldn't use that automatic starter anyway, because no button is gonna be as fun as the way I light my Kamado Joe.
Say hello to my little friend.
There's only two kinds of pitmasters in this world, those with flamethrowers and those with matches.
It puts the flame upon the wood, or else it gets the grill gun again.
Keep your friends close and your grill gun closer.
So the big innovation, the thing that they're really excited about, the stuff that they say is going to be a game changer for backyard grilling, is this integrated four-channel thermometer and controller and an integrated fan in the grill. Now that's not really a step forward though. Like not when 2 years ago Kamado Joe came out with the iCommand, right? So that's a module that you can attach to any Kamado Joe that has the same thermometer, the same controller. It's a fan that, but instead of being built in the back, it actually snaps on the front and provides airflow through to control the temperature of your Kamado Joe. I mean, this isn't new. The new thing is that it's integrated. As a matter of fact, when it came out 2 years ago, it wasn't revolutionary then. It was a new entrant into an already crowded space that had folks like Fireboard Labs and ThermoWorks and Barbecue Guru that all had products that did the same thing. A temperature monitor with a probe at grate level that monitors the temperature of the grill, and then a fan that controls the airflow in or out of your grill. Like, this is an established industry. And to be honest, I'm not thrilled with the idea of integrating it as opposed to leaving it as a standalone product. With it integrated, obviously that's why you're not allowed to keep this thing out in inclement weather, whether you're using it or not, and it can't be exposed to rain, right? But the fan is a mechanical piece. Like, if something's gonna break, it's gonna be mechanical, and then what's that gonna be like to repair? I mean, I'm sure it's gonna be covered under warranty, but are you gonna have to open up the back and do surgery to replace the fan? How hard is it gonna be to replace the electronics? I mean, if you gotta replace one of these external units, you literally just replace the external unit. They literally just snap onto the front. But by the way, we're talking about Kamado Joe. Like, I don't even know if this is necessary. If you've been here before and you've watched a couple of my Kamado Joe videos, you've noticed I haven't used one of those controllers since getting the Big Joe. The Kamado Joe, as I mentioned in almost every video, is incredibly good at maintaining temperature. Like, once you get it dialed in with the control tower top and the bottom vent, like, I never have to use it. As a matter of fact, my friend James from Smoking Dad Barbecue used to make fun of me with my Big Green Egg that I had to use it because he's never used one in his videos and he always is able to maintain temperature, even overnight. But maybe we do. Like, maybe some of us need that peace of mind. Maybe some of us need an electronic device and a fan and a controller to make sure that the temperature is exactly right all the time. I mean, maybe we'll sleep better when we do overnight cooks knowing that it's gonna be maintained and that there's a device that's gonna tell us if something goes wrong, right? Maybe we'll just have less anxiety if we've got all of that together. So if I want a Kamado Joe that I can keep outside and not worry about rain, but that still has all those connected properties and has a slow roller and can use like any of the Kamado Joe accessories, the Joe-tisserie or the Dojo or really anything, how do I do that? Like this. So what I've got in my hand is the signals from ThermoWorks, and you saw me put the fan, the Billows fan on from ThermoWorks earlier. But like I mentioned, there's lots of these. Like, you don't have to get a ThermoWorks one. If you want one, I'll put a link down in the description, but this is a four-channel thermometer, just like the one that they built in on the Konnected Joe. It's got a pit probe that I have on the grate, but notice that it's not on the back lid over the hottest part of the Kamado Joe. I can actually move this clip and put it anywhere up front, wherever my food is gonna be. And when I'm done, I take it all down. Like, I disconnect the probe, I take it in and I wash it. I take my signals or whatever other thermometer I'm using, I bring it in the house. If it's raining, it's no big deal. Like, this lives outside whether it's raining or not. And even this lives in my kitchen, but it's IP66 certified, which is like a splash rating, so like a light rain I can use it. But if it's really bad, if there's a gully washer, there's this additional device that you can get down here in North Carolina. Actually, you can get this in the North too. This is a special waterproofing device that you can put your electronics in here in North Carolina. You can even get it up in Canada, I understand you can get these. And then you just close this down, and now you can use this outside because it's not built into the grill. For a couple of $100, I've taken my Big Joe 2, which is already a superior grill, added the connectivity, and now I have a better grill than the Konnected Joe. And wait for this, you can do this on a Big Green Egg too. Same thing, it works on any of the Kamados. So you don't need to replace your Big Green Egg, you don't need to replace your Kamado cooker, you don't, when you're buying a new one, don't need to go buy the Konnected Joe. You can have all that it has to offer and more for cheaper by doing this piecemeal.
Next week, I'm gonna do a test that'll air in a couple of weeks to see if the slow roller works in the Big Green Egg and if that's really the only secret you need to get Kamado Joe quality barbecue out of a Big Green Egg. And in the meantime, a message for our friends at Kamado Joe, that is if we're still friends right now. So the Series 2, great innovation. The Series 3, amazing. You made our food better. But since then, I mean, what's with this kettle thing that you didn't need to do? And a pellet Kamado that really is out of left field. And now this connected thing? Come on, let's get back to real innovation. Let's make better food together, because that's why I'm on Team Red. I'll see you next week on Eat More Vegans.